Hey, quick disclaimer. Enjoy the video.
Are you tired of moments like this? Do you wish you had some better information of how temp works? Well, in this tutorial guide, you will know how to survive in temp. And trust me, this guide will guarantee you are able to win at least one match. Of course, we can't 100% guarantee your success in some matches. But at least, you will leave this video with a good knowledge about how the mechanics, the environment, and most things in game works. Now let's go right to it. First, you.
Oh great, the VHS broke again. Oh, hi there, I'm Charlin, I make temp videos for the past 5 months. And today, I'm gonna teach you guys how to survive in Cursed Tank Simulator. So, I have noticed that recently a lot of people, and when I mean a lot, it's a lot of people, are not subscribed. So, I have a better idea to motivate you guys to subscribe to my channel. Here we have Bob. Say hi, Bob.
Where am
well,
I?
Bob right here won't be having a good time.
What the fuck? Where am I?
If you don't like and subscribe.
No, 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 no.
So
no,
wait. Subscribe please, blow up his brains out.
You can't kill me.
Alright, I think everyone has already subscribed.
What, wait, Charlie, you have a YouTube channel?
And I noticed recently that a lot of old players and new players are struggling with some things in game, such as holes, turrets, terrain, you name it. So I decided to make not one, but 5 different videos explaining some things and tips for each tier of the game. This video, however, is only going to explain the main core of the game. The next videos will be released soon. So let's jump into it. Let's start off with the basics of the GUI. You have the garage and the dealership bottom on top. The garage is the most important one once you log on the game. Down here is your line of tanks. On the right side is all your types of stats, your tank stats, your daily missions, your normal stats, and servers that are online. On top here you have your currency and your level. On the daily rewards tab, you can see all the rewards on the month. Each of them can be obtained by completing each daily task. The tier that you're on. The servers tab, where you can see all the servers that are online, including the custom servers. Down here on customize, you can access all the parts that you can build on your tank, including the hull, the turret, and the cannon. In the inventory section, you can access all your materials. Pressing this tab, you will access your crates inventory. These crates will drop every time you play a match, even if you lose. Inside those crates, you can obtain materials, and those materials you can use to craft blueprints. Now let's talk about the dealership. In the dealership, you can purchase tank parts. Let's first start with Joe's Shack. In the Joe's Shack, all you need to do is purchase and use the tank part. It's very simple, there's no extra steps. You can access a lot of variations of hulls, turrets, and cannons here. On the blueprints, however, there's one extra step, which is the crafting. You need to purchase a blueprint and then craft with your materials that you win on the crates. And the blueprints section is very special because a lot of different tanks are in here. They play different, they look different, they're nice, they're neat, and most overpowered stuff are in here too. Like, just look at that scrap. Let's talk about the movement. You move with AWSD, you might have already know that. You can go back and forth, turn left and right, but when you turn left and right while not going forward, you neutral stare. What's neutral staring is when you stop in a single place and you rotate your tank. The tracks move opposite ways, making it turn side to side, so you can rotate your tank to different positions. If you want to move and turn, you have to go forward and turn right or left. Let's start with some camera controls. By pressing the letter C on your keyboard, you lock your turret, which means it will not move until you release the key. This is great for people that are holding angles and don't want your turret to move around when you're looking. Some tanks have coax guns, a secondary. You can use them by pressing the spacebar. By pressing shift, you open the gunner's optic. You can zoom in using the scroll wheel of your mouse, and you can also range find it by pressing the right mouse button. You can press the letter X so you can X-ray your tank. You can see all the modules and crew that are damaged or not. By pressing B, you open your binoculars. These are great for spotting enemies at longer ranges and from angles that you usually wouldn't see them. You can switch your ammo types by pressing twice the numbers on your keyboard. You can also pre-select the next loading shell by just pressing it once. And in some tanks, you have smoke launchers. By pressing the letter G, you can throw the smokes. And some tanks have different smoke launchers. For example, the engine smoke, which pops the smoke from the engine covering your whole tank. There's also the normal smoke canister, which pops a grenade in the air covering you up. And most likely German tanks have also the smoke canister, but explodes on the ground. And some tanks can also throw smokes all around himself, from the front, from behind, from the sides, you name it. In this game we have a realistic damage system, which means that you won't be joining a match, seeing a guy with a health bar on the top of his tank, you shoot it, you explode it, the end, you won, no. In this game we have a realistic style of damage. Let's take as an example a flat plate against a solid AP round. Let's take this gun's stats as a measurement, and it can penetrate this 100mm plate. After the penetration, it will release what we call shrapnel or spall. This will cause damage to crew and models. The damage indicator is defined in colors. The darker the color, the worse is the condition of the crew or the module. The darker the color of any part, the worse is its effectiveness in battle. And after you damage somebody, you will see a hit cam, which will show all these lines and colors, so if you want, pause the video and see the penetration indicator so you know which line means what. And now I'm going to explain the various ammunitions that we have in game. We have the armor piercing round, the AP, the APHE, the heat round, the APDS round, HE, heat FS rounds, HESH, and finally APFSDS rounds, and ATGMs. I'm going to explain all of them for you based on kinetic energy and chemical energy rounds. Let's start with the Kimco rounds, starting off with the APHE, which is a normal AP round but with a TNT charge in a fuse. After penetration, the shell will explode inside the tank, dealing a lot of damage on the crew and modules. The heat round, however, does not penetrate but have a TNT charge. After entering in contact with the surface of the tank, it will release a heat charge inside of it, causing a lot of focus damage. High explosive rounds work differently from other chemical rounds. It has a low penetration value, but in return there's a lot of TNT in each round. Its main objective is to destroy light tanks using its overpressure, caused by the explosion. More kilograms of TNT, the greater the damage. However, one of these ammunitions, called Hash, has a rubberized head that stretches across the surface after the contact. It's spreading all the explosive and forcing his way into the tank, causing a lot of chemical damage. Now, about kinetic energy rounds, I have already explained to you guys how the AP round works. And now I'm going to explain about their younger brothers, which is the APDS and the APFSDS. Okay, so what does APDS and APFSDS mean? It means by armor piercing discarding sable, and armor piercing fins stabilize discarding sable. Okay, but what is a sable? How does the shell work? Well, the shell has two parts. There's the sable and the main shell, which is a steel dart. The sable is just there to keep the shell going straight when going off the cannon, so it keeps his aerodynamic and precision when firing. After the shell is launched, the sable will be discarded. The impressive speed of the steel dart makes it very hot, and this heat helps in its penetration against the heavy armor, making its penetration values very high. In addition, the heat that is generated after the penetration causes a lot of more damage to the crew. And the APDS shell works basically the same, it's just that it uses a very low caliber compared to the APFSDS. And we also have the pros and cons about using those shells, but the pros, more likely that you get more penetration, more velocity on the shell, more module damage. But in low calibers you get a very lack of spall and very lack of spall damage, but overall it's one of the best shells in the entire game. Alright, I know what the shells do, I know how to control my tank, I know how two things work, I know how damage works, but how do I defeat a tank? Well, for you to defeat a tank there's two ways, and only two ways to defeat a tank. Neither you knock out all the crew members on the enemy tank, or you blow up their ammo rack. By shooting the ammo box, it will explode inside, killing everything that is in it. So those are the basic two ways to kill an enemy tank. Just knock all the crew or explode his insides.
Hey, Carolyn from the future here. I kind of forgot to explain the ammo racks, so here's a quick explanation. Ammo racks is where your ammo is stored, and also acts as a weak spot. To prevent dying too quickly, I recommend bringing a low ammo count, like 10 to 15, depending on the tank and the gun of course. Less ammo racks, more survivability.
You can also tell that I'm burned out using this AI as voice.
Danganronpa.
From this part and onwards of the video, I will not be wasting time, and I'm going to teach you guys, share with you some of my knowledge from playing Tank, so you guys can be a real Tanker. I will not be talking what's the best money method or what's the best tank to use. I'm just going to share with you guys some good advice of how to get better in the game. Things like knowing your situation, your surroundings, things that can make you improve in the game. The first part is... Welcome to Viewer Mail Time, the part of the video that I pick one of your comments and read it out loud to the internet. I made a community post 1 month ago where I asked you guys to send me commentaries so I can read only one of them on my next 5 videos, but you guys didn't got the memo quite well, so I'm going to read not one but both comments that people sent. Yeah.
When did you started playing Tamk?
I started playing Tamk, if I'm not wrong, back in September or October of 2022.
What made you get into World War II vehicles?
Well, the World War II era is the most fascinating to me, like the most creative stuff. You got like very good tanks, very bad tanks, and some that are just stupid to work. And that's our first viewer mail time. If you want to participate on this, always check my community tab for when I announce it. See you next time! Before you start blasting every single tank on your way, you need to first know all the game modes there are available in-game right now, which are the Deathmatch game mode, the Defense game mode, the Skirmish game mode, and the Conquest game mode. But before we go to explaining them, we need to know how do I win a match. After you join a match, you will see on the top of the screen two bars. One is blue and one is red. These are the ticket counters. Your main objective on the match is to drain all enemy tickets. Tickets are drained in two situations, one of them being any of the teams maintaining a capture point for a certain amount of time, and the second way of draining tickets is after any of the teams spawn in. Every time you spawn, you will drain 30 tickets if I'm not wrong, but the main objective doesn't change. The first team to lose all their tickets or have less tickets than the enemy team is the winner. Since the main objective doesn't change at all, we're going to speedrun every single game mode. Starting with Team Deathmatch, no objectives, just killing. Kill everyone. Defense game mode. You have 2 points. Neither you defend yours or you capture the enemy team. Holding that point for too long will guarantee your victory. The skirmish is just like domination. You have one major capture point, hold it for long enough and you will win. Conquest, you have 3 capture points. Maintain all 3 to guarantee a max drain on the enemy tickets. If you want to survive a match in Tamk, you need to be prepared for everything. Any type of tank, any type of enemy, any type of situation. So I recommend you guys to build a very balanced setup of tanks. Most likely you'll be bringing some medium tanks, probably one heavy tank, some light tanks, and some auto cannons if you wish. And I can already hear the jeers, yeah, I know, auto cannon, I say the word. But you guys need to understand that the auto cancer or the auto cringe or whatever you call it is just a normal weapon like any other. You're just trading the powerful and destructive power of larger calibers to a smaller one that fires way faster but deal less damage. It is an assist tool for your team.
Hey, but you defeated the auto cancer, you're cringe, they're noobs. They don't deserve living, they are all trash. You are a trash for using auto cannons, you don't deserve a life.
Now that you stopped crying, let me explain why you should bring at least one auto cannon, and it's just one word of explanation. Light tanks. Light tanks are hell, they are rats, they are everywhere, sneaking behind your team, killing everyone before you see it, and if you don't kill them first, oh boy, they will sure flank your ass and kill you. So you must have a quick fire weapon to kill them fast, since they are light, they have no armor. Like, just look at this bastard, I missed it 2 shots and he's already like running away thinking that I'm not looking at him. Just die finally. Oh damn. That's why I tell you guys to bring an autocannon. You can't afford missing shots on those types of guys. They're fast, they're unpredictable, so you need to just have a quick gun to spray at them and guarantee your kill. And most light tanks are like 50mm, 30mm, so you have no trouble getting through them. Unless it's like a half light tank, so you might want to just go around and shoot their sights, but always mix an autocannon with a light tank. One thing that all players should know is that several things will be happening in a single match. You're probably gonna be lost among all the sounds, all the shots, and all the tanks being destroyed. And if you don't pay attention for even 1 second, it's game over for you. That's why it's important to know your surroundings and your current situation in the match. So let's go with in parts to make it easier to you guys understand. Audio is very important to the basic gameplay of the game. Everything around you will make some type of sound that can be very useful for you to identify your situation. Be it a tree or another prop being broken, the enemy engine or any gunfire, all of these sounds can help you, most of the time of course. You want to be as silent and as quiet as possible, so you can hear the enemy and the enemy can't hear you. So please, I beg you, play with headphones. It's almost a mandatory thing. You need to use audio to play the game. Using your binoculars can be a very good strategy for looking at positions ahead from a different angle that may or may not reveal an enemy. In recent updates, from 300 meters and forward, you cannot see the opponent's name tag anymore, making it very difficult to identify enemies far away. So I recommend you guys to practice your field of vision and plan where to move and where to hide so you can ensure your survival. Knowing where the enemy is a major, major advantage for your team and yourself. One thing I keep saying is that people generally don't think before going to combat. Even if they aren't running like crazy to the front line or just holding a point, people forget to choose the best target that will benefit you and your team. Let's imagine a situation. There's three tanks in front of you. They didn't see you, but you know that no matter where you shoot them, you will kill them, but just one of them. The other ones have a high chance that when their teammate dies, they will react and fire at you back. There's a tank destroyer in front of you, which has very light armor, but it has a big cannon. There's a very poor medium tank mate, like there's a newbie behind that wheels. And there's an average player playing a heavy tank with a very average weapon. Which one of them you shoot first? In this situation, we have several possibilities. It's clear that one player there is very experienced, and in my opinion, I would choose to eliminate neither the tank destroyer or the heavy tank, because I feel that the guy with the most armor or the guy with the most powerful weapon can really be a pain in the ass for your team. Or if you don't have a team and you're playing by your own, it will be a big problem for you afterwards. And even if you die after the whole situation, you will be sure that the main threat won't be there waiting for you to kill you. When I say abusing the system, I don't mean by money hacks or wall hacks or overthrowing the goddamn government. I mean by tank parts. You can literally bring a equipment that from a tier above would be very bad, would be mid, would work well, but in your tier can be the most devastating weapon of them all. The rule is, if you're carrying items that are from the minimum rank of your tier, let's take a tier 5, 6 as an example. If you assemble a tank with parts from tier 5, you can bring either a cannon or a hull or a turret from one tier above, which is the tier 7. You can also combine a high tier hull with a tier 5 turret and a tier 6 cannon. The possibilities are endless, so abuse the system. Get better equipment than the others on your tier. Be a menace of society. Now, one thing that I implore for all of you to understand is that this game is a line of learning. Basically, get good. Increase your knowledge about everything around the game. Study the most detailed mechanics that almost no one understands. Study the probabilities, the weak points of each tank on your rank. Increase your knowledge about everything. And I will show you some topics that you must learn and study and get good about it. If you are struggling to fight against a certain hull or turret, I recommend that you guys, as soon as the match ends, go to Joe Shack or the Blueprint tab and find that one turret or hull that the opponent were using. After you find it, click on the item and click on Inspect, which you'll be sent to a model of it where you can see all the weak spots and all the armor measurements. Let's take a look at the mouse, for example. It's a tier 8, but in this part right here, has less than 150mm of armor, and most tanks at this tier has over 240mm of penetration. So this is a weak spot, and every single tank has their own weak spot. So find them, exploit them, win. I recommend you also study all the maps in the game. Each part of each map, each control point, each place where to camp and enjoy some kills, know where to hide, where not to go, and where to go, find the best route for you, and where the enemies might appear. Just remember, knowledge is power. If you know where to go, you know where they might come, you know how to predict them. Learn to predict your opponent's move. You know that part in the video where I explain about the combat system? Where I mentioned some mechanics? Well, I left several other mechanics unmentioned in that part of the video, as they were either too detailed or too complicated for the topic of this video. But since this is a guide for beginners and average players, I will mention these mechanics so you can get a taste of what's to come. And the mechanics are APS, Active Protection System, ATGM, Guided Missiles, ATGMs as a secondary weapon, on top attack ability, full aim, radars, it's a lot of things, and all these things will appear on my video on how to survive at tier 7-8 or the video on how to survive in tier 9-10 or 12-11. Wait, you can just press F1 at any time in the game and see everything I just talked about? All this 20-minute video of me explaining things could be just solved by pressing F1. Okay, you guys are too lazy. I can't anymore. Here, have your certificate. You did it. You completed the tutorial. You completed the guide. I'm out of here. I ain't doing this shit again. Bye.